If you just met like a visitor from a foreign country who had never been in the United States before, and they just happened to be here today, and you'd have to explain to them what this Thanksgiving Day is all about, how'd you go about doing it? You know, if you were historically inclined, you might say that it has its roots in a pilgrim feast in the autumn of 1621. Or you could say that our first president, George Washington, proclaimed it a national day of Thanksgiving on November 26th in 1789. Or you could say that Abraham Lincoln formally established the observance of the last Thursday of November in 1863 as a national day of Thanksgiving. And then at the height of the Civil War, FDR changed it slightly in 1939 by making Thanksgiving the fourth Thursday of November to encourage holiday shopping during the Great Depression. I think we've all overcome the Great Depression when it comes to shopping in this country anymore. But I would think that everybody else, if somebody asked you, well, what do you do for Thanksgiving? Well, you might say, well, of course, we sit down and we have a lot of food, don't we? We go through what we always have. We have turkey and mashed potatoes and green beans and candied yams and pumpkin pie. And of course, you can't eliminate football from the equation when you're thinking of Thanksgiving. But I think just about any person would say in their explanation of Thanksgiving that Thanksgiving is the day that the people in the United States have set aside to reflect on all the blessings they have in their lives and to say thank you. And that's not a bad explanation. And it's interesting too that there are specific prayers and readings for a secular holiday in our church calendar, such as Thanksgiving. And it's interesting that this particular gospel of the healing of the lepers was chosen. The lepers in today's gospel were isolated. The human beings had become a thing to be avoided because they were robbed of all social contact other than being with one another. And lepers were deprived of the dignity of labor. Therefore, they don't have the chance to be co-creators with the Lord. And when these 10 lepers were healed, think of the celebration that they must have had to reintegrate themselves back into society. And it was amazing that only one stopped to reflect where such a blessing came from and to say thank you. So we gather today as a nation to stop and reflect on God's presence in our lives and say thank you. But the question is one day sufficient? And maybe for some people, that is. But the Christian life is about ongoing reflection, daily reflection on how God is working in our lives. And we know that the word Eucharist actually means thanksgiving. If we condition ourselves to stop every day and to reflect where we've seen the Holy Spirit work in our lives, I think that we would be amazed. So amazed that the only words necessary would be thank you. And for a person having eyes thus conditioned by the Holy Spirit, every day is Thanksgiving Day.